come and get a real good buy. That's why I come here. We have some great values here at the show.
This show is one of the finest and the most best assorted shows for jewelry and watches in New York.
They are the most trusted dealers in the world.
The antique show here in New York is very, very special, very unique in that all of the best antique jewelry dealers are in one place.
I've been short exhibiting for over 20 years. They run the show beautifully. Having been with other shows, I find that these shows are second to none.
It's absolutely a great opportunity for buyers to come here and purchase the jewelry. And this is a safe place. All the jewelers here who sell are reputable jewelers, many years in business, and everything is guaranteed 100%.
It's where all the dealers come, as well as the privates. And New York being a major metropolitan city and a cosmopolitan city, people like to come and purchase.
47th Street is right here. All the diamond dealers come down. Everybody's really eager to buy product. There's a huge shortage. So it's exciting for us, and we do a lot of business here. So we're thrilled to be here.
One of the best things about the New York show is the staff and the people that run the show, but we also get traffic from an international customers throughout the world, and plus a lot of local dealers come here because it's the only one in the New York area.
Well, New York show being the epicenter of the world, we want to see, present all the jewelry for our customers to come and see what the industry can present for them.
I think the best thing about the New York show is the diversity. It's a chance we see all of our European clients. We have fabulous people from the city that are retail customers. And really kind of to regroup and see everyone before fall. Love it. It's a great show.
This is a necklace with seven blackamoors, six which are 18th century and one which is 19th century on a necklace which is 19th century. Each one is a seal. These six I would think are probably German and this one is English, but the necklace is actually Italian.
All right, this piece is a J.E. Caldwell ring, the center of which is a carat 75 pure red diamond. Red diamonds are the rarest stones in the world. They are much more rare than a blue diamond or a pink diamond or a yellow diamond. And it happens to be in a J.E. Caldwell ring that was manufactured for J.E. Caldwell by Oscar Hyman, a New York company that was very famous for making all the branded jewelry in its day.
Well, we have a wonderful set by Van Cleef & Arpels, and this is from collection Lucille Ball, and this is from 1963. It features yellow sapphires, natural, with a diamonds, and set in yellow gold. So it's absolutely beautiful piece, and it's up for sale now. And also, the set I'm wearing it belongs to collection John Collins. It's a beautiful earrings and a pin, and it has yellow gold, platinum, and diamonds.
First piece here is a fabulous piece, probably circa 1980. Has about 25 carat of diamonds, fabulous collection goods, South Sea pearls, just a wonderful piece of jewelry. Also have a fabulous French bracelet, about 1930. Has about 25 carat of goods, just a fabulous example of great Art Deco. And down in front we have the most wonderful pair of night and day earrings, circa 1950, probably about 20 carats of diamonds. And the neat thing about it is, if you're bored with one look, you can take off the bottom tassels and have a little more casual view.
This piece was a one-off made in 1952. It's made of diamonds, 14 karat gold, which is the normal thing in America, and natural turquoise. I purchased it because it was so special, and I do love objects, and it's a one of a kind. I can't give you much more information than that. And this piece has an influence of jade and the Mughal era, but also the Art Deco era.
You know, this is a very interesting piece. It's all original Rolex. It's almost $80,000 retail. You can't find this watch in any Rolex windows in the States, for the most part, unless you're in Vegas. The only place you can see many watches like this is in Hong Kong on every street corner. So this is a very obscure watch, and because it's pre-owned, it represents excellent value if somebody's interested in this type of item. This is Piaget. What makes this very interesting is you commonly see this watch in white gold. This is platinum. They only ever made 30 examples like this in the world. So you won't find another one like it for sale anywhere. This is one of the most interesting watches that we have in stock at the moment. It's the new Presidential, so it's the Day-Date 2. The most interesting part of this watch is that it's rose gold. You can't find a pre-owned rose gold Day-Date 2 anywhere except for here right now.
We're specialized in signed estate jewelry and color diamonds. And we have here presenting Tiffany 1920s and Van Cleef & Arpels 1960s. And this is Harold Winston earrings, cushion cut, with a micro pavé work. And we have other pieces with all signed estate. And we have some diamonds with exquisite colors, blue, red, yellow, or orange colors. That's why we're specialized in.
We just acquired a really beautiful Castellani necklace from Castellani from 1860. Fortuitous to us because we own the Castellani company in London, England. And we particularly like to buy crown jewelry, which we have a beautiful Edwardian crown, because that's our logo for both our Under the Crown and Bernard & Acme company as well.